Hello, today I want to show you how to create RSS email in Mailchimp without any plugins. You'll have to log into Mailchimp account, go to campaigns, click all, click create, select automation, and here we will use classic automation. And here we will have to set share block updates. You will need to add the name for your campaign. Let's name it test because I already have share block updates campaign existed. And here you will have to select your audience. Mine is this one. Click begin. Here in the first field, you will have to add your RSS feed URL. If you don't know what's your website feed URL, it's easy to find. You'll just have to go to your website. So for example, if your website is, let's say, gmail.com, you'll have to add slash and feed, and that's where you will get their link. So in my case, it will be looking like this. And here I can grab the exact URL, which is this. Copy and paste it right here. Make sure the link is correct and it doesn't have anything except thread extension. Otherwise, their update will be wrong. After that, you will have to select a schedule if you want to be scheduled every day, every week, every month, and what time of the day. Here you can select if you want to send it all these days or specific days, etc. I always check this box to make sure that it resides in properly, and that's it here. So click next. Here you will have to select your audience. It can be a specific segment, group, or entire audience. In my case, it's entire audience, so I'm not changing anything here and clicking next. Here you will have to add the name. It's already after field, but you can update it if you want. Here you will see how the email subject will look like. It's also editable, so you can add whatever else you need here. You can add preview text if you want. Here you will have to add from name, from email address, check some boxes. I usually check few. If you have e-commerce, you can also check e-commerce. If you want this feed to be auto-tweeted to the Twitter, you will have to add your Twitter URL. And if you want to auto-convert the video, you can also check that and other settings. I am done here, so let's click next. And on the next stage, that's where you create your template. You can choose some themes they offer, some saved templates if you have some, and also you have campaigns and you can code your own. But we are going to create it from scratch. So we go to layout, scroll down the page and select something what is available for free. As you can see, only a few templates are free and the rest is not. So we are going to use something like this and just substitute the blocks and delete text, replace if we need to. On the right side, you have all these options, so you can basically create all of this from scratch, but the specific blocks will be already added. So let's say we want to add the logo on the top, so I'm going to remove this top section and drag and drop the image like this. So it has to be blue, and that's how you drag and drop. So now we can upload our logo. So I just find this logo for this testing purposes. Let's insert. Now it looks big, but we can change it. So we can edit the sizing right here. I'm just going to, I don't know, maybe do it like this, resize it manually. But if you know your exact logo proportions, that is great. I don't, so I'm just playing around. So okay, now it looks a little different. Still not ideal, but for this case it's okay. Here you will have to add some text, so maybe let's see. Name it Hello Traveler, here are your, here are your weekly updates. You can also change the font here, the colors. So for example, you want to look at like this, it's too bright, so let's just, let's use this one maybe. Let's change the size to 18. And if you want your email to be personalized, so it will show the person's name, you'll just have to go to merge tags and add the first name. Right now it looks like this, but once the real email will be sent, it will say the exact name. So for example, it will say, instead of hello travelers, it will say hello Elena. In that case, you'll have to add merge tags right here, so it's not general. And I believe people usually like to be mentioned exactly. So now we're just going to add first name right here, and that's all. So here we will start creating our actual images. So for example, here I want to add some blog post, and I'll have to replace this image with something I already have. Let's say we're gonna use this one, insert, so the image as added. You can also edit it. You can also change the sizing right here. So maybe we can keep it as is. Here I'm going to replace the context, and I will add their existing link. So for example, let's go to some of my posts and grab any post, so we want to add that. So for example, this one, I'm just copying the link, go here, paste. We're going to replace it soon, so now we will need to add the actual name, not the link. So I'll just name it 48 hours in Melbourne, and now we're going to hyperlink this title. We just have to highlight, click on this icon, paste the link, insert, and that's it. I also want to change the color so it matches my website color, and it's going to be so. Okay, so now it's changed. In here I want to add some meta description, which will let user know what this is about. So for that, I will just go to my WordPress and grab it from here and add it right here, and it's pretty much ready. So okay, I'm gonna keep it as is. And next is, you see, you can see this button here. And let's say you want to add click to call action, and you will just have to click on the section again and change the text. For example, start traveling. And let's say you want to send this user to your homepage on your website. For that, you will just have to add the homepage link right here directly, save and close. And that's all. And let's say the next section you want to be recent blog post update. So here you will just have to maybe add another section first to name it that this is the section for the recent blog posts. Okay, I'm having trouble to add it right here, so let's first edit this. We will need to replace this default image with something else. Let's use this one. And let's also replace it right away for the column first. And maybe this one. So as you can see, they are different sizes, but you will just need to make sure that both of the images are the same size so they look nice. And now we will have to also edit the text. So this is column 1. And here, I'm not going to go into more details. This is pretty much the same scenario as we did earlier. You will just have to replace it with your text. For example, travel chip is the title. Here you will need to add some subtext, and you can also add the link like this, and you can also change the color to whatever you want. And let's quickly update the number 2. This may be best travel deal, and we will change it to something like this. So these are pretty much done. And if you want to add the same block or similar, you can just copy and edit. So same thing here, you will just have to replace the images and replace the text and add the links and anything else you might want to add. So this is pretty easy to do. Also, you can edit the footer. Here, I don't want to use social icons, so I'm going to delete that. We can also change the background of the footer section. So, for example, you want it to be red, you want it to be different color. And we're gonna just keep it as is. It's too dark now. Maybe let's make it a little less. And here you can also change the font size and color and etc. This is pre-built footer we've already built in address, so for your case you'll have to do it prior to that. And here you can also change some style settings, and let's say you want to be just 2 columns, you can also do that here. And let's just add the section right here. We don't need this button, so I'm going to delete that. And also, if you want to change the position of your sections, you can just like drag and drop, hold it and move it like this. Don't forget to close, but I believe it's after closing, so let's try to add the text section here, and we're gonna say recent posts, and that's the section above. So we are done right here. And basically, if you would like to add any other details in your email template, you'll just have to manually come here and add them or change them. So this is super quick, and this email will be sent to your subscribers on the same day and time you just set in the beginning of this tutorial. So now we are clicking next, but before that I want to also mention that you can preview your email. So you have to click enter preview mode, and here you will see how it looks. Here you can see how it looks on mobile, and if you enable this toggle you will see their recipient name. Please keep in mind that on your test email you won't see the actual name, it will always say hello test, something like that, but don't worry, it is only on your test email. In the real email, it will say the name. And here you can also send a test email to yourself to check if it's working properly. You can save as a template before exit, you can save and exit. And when you go next, here you will see if there are any problems and if you need to change something. So right now we see default text content we need to resolve, so let's click resolve and let's see what we have left here. So I believe they're complaining about this pre-existing text, so I'm just going to remove it. And add something silly just to have it here, and let's use this one too. Done. Let's click next and let's see if it is fixed now. Okay, looks not good yet, so let's go back. Okay, so we had a second block we didn't change. Now it should be fixed. Yep, looks good. So once we click start RSS, it will ask for our confirmation, and if you are sure, you will just have to click start campaign and you will see the final confirmation that the campaign is set and scheduled. I won't be doing that right now because this is just for testing purposes. I'm not going to save it and start it, but that's how you create the RSS email without any plugins, and it will be sent directly to your subscribers on the exact time and day. And that's it for today. Thank you for watching.